You're on the 100x Zoom channel. Today I have this one for you. Well, I wouldn't say it's very rare, but you don't often see it in video reviews. I have this binocular, the first one. I've had it sitting in my storage for about a year, so maybe a year and a half. I just never got around to it. The binoculars are from the English company Ross S750. From the serial number 23032, we can say that the binoculars were manufactured around the beginning of the 1940s. There were many binoculars of similar shape at that time. There were also military binoculars that had a reticle grid. I can't remember if it's on the right or the left eyepiece. Even before I started my YouTube channel, I had a similar binocular in green color. There was almost nothing written on it. Maybe there was something under the paint, but it looked like this. It was completely covered in green paint. This binocular has its own feature, specifically this middle part. Here are the prisms. And the prisms here are of the poro type, but they're a bit different. Some call them poro type 2. Actually, that's a bit too far. First, let me unscrew the binoculars, take them apart, and get these prisms out so I can tell you a bit more about them. In terms of specifications, these binoculars have a 7x magnification, a 50 millimeter objective lens diameter, a 7 degree field of view, and an ocular field of view of 50. That is, these binoculars are not wide angle, that is, standard binoculars with a standard field of view. Well, now let's move on to the actual image in the binoculars. The right half is very strong, dirty, with mold. The lens, or on the right eyepiece, has a problematic lens, while the left half is somewhat better. Well, the image is still somewhat dirty. Well, now I begin to disassemble the binoculars themselves. You know, when repairing Soviet binoculars or relatively modern Zeiss ones, it somehow gets tiresome. But here, the binoculars are of a relatively different design. And repairing the binoculars even brings some satisfaction. The eyepiece in these binoculars is somewhat unusual. Here is one lens. Well, one group of lenses in this part that I'm holding. There is a cemented joint in it. And there is a problem with that joint. And another lens is glued to the prisms themselves. I unscrewed three screws that hold the prism cover. There are no threads on the prism cover, but it is very corroded, so you need to assist yourself. Well, somehow, assist to remove the cover. And now look at these prisms. You see, the field lens is glued to one of the prisms. These prisms, if I'm not mistaken, because there is a lot of different information on the internet, and I hope I processed it correctly. These prisms are called either poro prisms of the second type or poro abe prisms. In some binoculars, these prisms are glued together. This allows for reduced losses during the transition, glass air glass. In this binocular, there is an air gap between them. But in that green binocular, it's a pity. I didn't record a video about it. It had three prisms, standard poro. One of them was of a large size, which turned the light beam by 180 degrees, and there were also two small poro prisms glued on, each of which turned the light beam by 90 degrees. Looking at this prism block, I'm curious about how the process of mounting the prisms was carried out. It seems like hot oil was dripped, and when it was still not solidified, each of the prisms was pressed into it. After that, you certainly have to hope that the binocular alignment will be perfectly fine, and in this particular case, the two prisms must be absolutely perfectly parallel. Precisely parallel, not perpendicular. Take another look at how these prisms appear. They have a lot of mirror surfaces from which the beam reflects at an angle of 45 degrees. Apparently, keeping them clean will be quite difficult. A beam enters the prism, then it reflects off one surface, it reflects off the next surface, and then it exits the first prism, and this is where the losses occur. They could be glued. In this place, if two prisms were glued together, it seems to me that it would be better. Well, then the beam enters the lens. The lens has a blackening. For example, if you take a binocular that has... The rotating system consists of two pornoprisms, and the glasses have two lenses, or two groups of lenses. Then, in the absence of illumination on the optics, in general, when there is none, these binoculars will be brighter, because they have two fewer glass-air-glass transitions. This bonding of the lens with the prism has its advantages. And if the two prisms were glued together as well, that would be another downside to transitions. And now we move on to the lenses. Let's unscrew the cap. And what do we see? We see that we immediately have a sleeve with lenses and a mounting ring. So there's no clamping ring here. And when you adjust the binoculars, you have to screw this cap on and look carefully to the lens didn't rotate. The lens in this sleeve is glued. Zrivito, honestly, I don't like it when the lenses are either rolled or glued because they are hard to remove. Well, maybe, but it's difficult. In some cases, it's dangerous. You can damage the lens. But to clean it, it doesn't come out perfectly. It doesn't come in corners. I barely unscrew the cap of the left objective. I had to use a wrench to help myself. Without it, I don't know if it will work. That's only half the task. You also need to screw it on so that the alignment doesn't get messed up. The right eyepiece has a problematic lens. I don't know what to do with it. I'm going to unscrew it now. Maybe I can unglue it. Although, I doubt it. As you can see, the lens is rolled. You can't just buy such a lens like that. So, that's how it will stay. Risk it and squeeze it out. I won't. Well, the binoculars are completely disassembled, and all the parts, except for the optics, have been thoroughly washed and cleaned. We just need to grease some moving parts, and then we can assemble everything. Well, but before that, we need to clean them well. Prisms? And prisms are not so easy to clean, as you can see. It's hard to hold them here. If you take a simple poro prism, you could take it and clean it like this. Its sides, then with these prisms, everything is much more complicated. You can easily leave fingerprints. 1. Set the prisms is ready. To be honest, it took me a little while as but I left some marks, even though I was wearing gloves. This prism with the lens was quite easy to clean, just hold the end of the lens. But this prism, which is directed towards the lens, was much more complicated there. As you can see, the whole process of assembling the binoculars, I didn't show it because there was nothing particularly complicated about it. I cleaned the lens as much as I managed to. Of course, if the lens could be removed from the housing, it would have been cleaned much better around the edges. I managed to do it. Of course, if the lens could be removed from the sleeve, it would be much better cleaned around the edges. But overall, it turned out pretty good. The worst is the lens, closest to the eyes in the right eyeglass. Maybe in the future there will be a donor from the same pair of binoculars approximately the same, and maybe the lens will be identical, then you can try erase and not be afraid that the lens will crack. So I decided to just clean it again and not push it, because it could have made things even worse. I conditionally made the observation with my own eyes. The binoculars do not double. The only problem is that this cap, which was very difficult to unscrew, I cannot screw it back on completely now. Therefore, I will have to put a few drops of glue in these places and then screw the cap on, but not completely. In general, I believe that this method of lens fixation is very unreliable. Well, to conclude, all that's left is to take some shots through these binoculars to show the quality of the image. I will say right away, the quality is quite good. As you can see, as they say, it's early, you see spring outside the window. And these binoculars show quite well, I must say, for their side. The clarity of the field of view is about 70%, which is quite good, but of course you can see that the edges start to blur a bit. Distortion is very minimal. The color reproduction is neutrally without any C color distortions. What I also really liked about these binoculars, and in general in other binoculars, is if they have a large depth of field, all of this that I am filming now, meaning the difference in distance of 5 kilometers, 2, and here even 500 meters, I am not refocusing the binoculars at all. That is, the image is essentially clear almost all the time. And here at a closer distance, it seems to me that the image has somehow improved, and the spherical aberration is not as noticeable as at a longer distance. Perhaps it was necessary to slightly refocus for the longer distance, but believe me, you can do without it. It's comfortable to look through the binoculars at any distance. Thank you all for watching the video, and see you next time.